Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones. Boy, a tough question today sent in via YouTube. Someone says they have two sheets, sheet one, sheet two. They want to be able to select some cells here, run a macro, and have Excel take those rows, cut them from here, paste them to the next row on sheet two, add a date on sheet two. All right, so let's take a look. I started to write some code here. First thing I do is I declare a couple of variables, object variables, WS1 and WS2 as worksheet. And then WS1 is the active sheet, whatever it happens to be. WS2 I define as sheet two. Now, there's a property called selection, and selection might be a single cell, it might be a number of rows. And so I'm going to set up a variable called first row is equal to selection dot rows plural 1.row. And what this is saying, hey, however many rows we happen to have in the selection, tell me the first one, tell me what row number it is, and then we'll figure out the row count. That's another variable, is equal to selection dot rows dot count. All right, next row on sheet two, how do we do this? We go down to the last cell in the sheet, we press the N key, press the up arrow key, see what row we're on. So next row is equal to WS2.cells, rows.count, comma 1, dot end, Excel up, dot row. That's going to get me to the last row with data, and I want to add 1 to that, plus 1, all right? And then the copy here, I already wrote this one. We start on WS1, copy from the first row, resize to be the row count. There were 8 columns, and the destination then is WS2, and we go to the next row. That's a variable. So, you know, the first time we run it, I'll probably go to row 2, but then I'll go later. All right, then they wanted to add a date. All right, so how are we going to do this? WS2.cells. All right, well, we know it's going to write to next row. Next row. There's 8 columns of data already, so we want to put that in the 9th column. And I'm going to resize it to be row count, comma 1. So, one column wide. Row count columns high dot value is equal to there's a variable called date. This is a built-in variable in VBA. It'll put the current date in there. And then back on WS1, delete those rows and shift Excel up. Now the reason I did a copy and then the delete, copy is nice in VBA in that I can be sitting on sheet one and copy to sheet two without ever going back to sheet two. Using cut, I wasn't sure that was going to work. So this seems to be a good way to go. Now, I wrote that macro without using the macro recorder. I want to go into macros. I want to look at the cut rows macro and click options. And this is where I can assign it to a shortcut key. Normally, with the macro recorder, we get to declare this up front. So now here's the big test. We'll select a few rows here. It looks like 4, 5, and 6. If I look on sheet 2, there's currently nothing. So we'll press Control M. The rows disappeared from here. 4, 5, and 6. If I look on sheet 2, they showed up in the correct place, and we have a date along the left-hand side. Let's try something else. I'll just try a single row, row 14, Control M. It disappears from here, and it shows up in row 4. Looks like we have it. So there you have it. 2, 4, 6, 7 lines of code plus the declaration to the top to solve that problem. So thanks for that question. Thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast, Mr. Excel.